Hey, this is Matt from Chef Pascal in the Worst Kitchen. And today, we're on location. We're in North Scituate, Rhode Island with Don Hopkins. And we're amongst sheep, lamb, you. We as chefs love lamb, but then there's sheep, and I get confused. So what is the main difference?
Age only.
Age only.
A lamb is 0 to 12 months old.
Okay.
A yearling is 12 to 24 months old, and then a mature sheep is 24 and over.
Okay. So the reason why we're out here, it's early spring, we're talking about a few things that are really important that you do in order to maintain your animals. Taking care of the land, fertilizing, and also shearing, which is
correct.
It's important for them, right?
Correct, it is. It's a maintenance issue. It's not anything that contributes significantly to our income. These are meat-orientated sheep. Yeah. Genetically, they're more prone to produce good quality carcasses as opposed to great quality wool. Their
right.
wool is usable, but not as good as what would be considered a wool breed.
So there are different breeds.
So there are
breeds that, because I was actually, when I was driving out, I was like, geez, I never even asked about making cheese. But so you said that there's different varieties. There are animals that are good that put on weight on their carcass.
Correct.
There are animals that are specifically meant for shearing, for wool blankets. I was going to wear my wool sweater today. And then there's ones that are meant for producing milk for cheese.
Correct.
And this variety here is specific for
meat. Our farm name, which is Hopkins South Downs, obviously my wife and mine last name, and South Downs, which is a breed of sheep that was developed in Europe, in England. They are known for their excellent carcass quality. We use predominantly South Down rams on a various group of ewes that have great mothering ability, mostly Dorset based. It's a different breed of sheep, is it called a Dorset, also originated from Europe.
So what I like about, you know, these animals and looking at this is that they're not necessarily that interested in us, except you said when they want to be fed.
They are. Then they're my best friend.
So twice
a day, they're my best friend.
Yeah, we're here and we're in their what's called as their bedding. So I always get confused too with straw and hay. Straw is something that you use for a bedding.
Right. It's very moisture absorbent. It is.
Well, what do you guys like?
It's the dried stems of small grains.
Yeah.
It's used just for bedding, and then hay is of a higher quality nutritional value. It's made from drying local grasses, which is what we feed, and we harvest the grass at its optimum point to get the highest nutritional value out of it.
Being spring, it's really important that you maintain your land.
It is.
And so you call it the sweepings from their beddings, it goes towards composting or spreading out on the grasses, right?
Yes, we spread manure twice a year, either in the fall or in the spring. We do not spread manure during frozen ground conditions due to runoff.
Which is important, and that was something
that's very important.
You had mentioned. So this is not just, you're not just here to raise animals. I mean, you have to know how to protect a watershed area.
That's right.
So it's really critical as far as the timing of fertilization,
of
shearing these animals. It's a labor of love.
We're in the town of Scituate, which is the watershed for the Providence Water Supply Board. 67% of the state gets their water from this town. So we have to be very conscious about protecting the water supply. The state of Rhode Island and NRCS work very close with me. We put up a manure storage barn, so if we clean pens during frozen ground conditions, it goes undercover so that there's no leaching that occurs.
Right, which is, I mean, again, it's just the whole idea of you have to think about this. And another thing I had asked you about is how did you get into this and what made you, you know, decide to raise these animals?
And both my wife and I have had sheep for over 50 years, excuse me.
It's amazing.
And
you said, like,
that's all we know.
when I was coming out today, I was like, oh, I'm going to be there around 9:30. I hope that's not too early. And you just write back, we start chores at 4:30, which I'm just like, I knew something like that was coming. But it's like people who ask me, they're like, Matt, when you're at home and you're off, do you cook all the time? And I was like, I don't look at as a job. It's just something that I do and I love to do it.
It's a passion.
And I think that's what you were saying. You were saying that you love to take care of these animals. I don't want to say it's a hobby because it's not.
It's not. It's a passion that we have to be able to have a revenue return from.
Right, because this is expensive.
There's 52 acres here that's been in my family for 6 to 7 generations that I can trace, and if there was not agriculture here, it would probably be a subdivision.
Right.
So it's terribly, especially with the pressure on land in a small town like Rhode Island, it's very important that
you maintain this.
Yes.
Yeah. And this is a great thing to do, because what you had said earlier, that this land really isn't great for tillage, because
it's not. It's terrible.
You would be a rock farmer.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Yeah. So this suits this land. I mean, you've thought about it, and this is what this land maybe was meant for.
You graze this, you do not till it.
Yeah.
You know, close friends of ours, like Wishing Stone Farm is something, they have great soil.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Limited rocks, that's tillable acreage.
That's because all the rocks came here.
That's right.
Yeah, and that's great too, because we're actually going to visit them. That's another one of our tours, that we're gonna go visit them. And Silas and Skip are gonna talk to us about grafting tomatoes, another early spring project that really has to be done. And they're going to tell us exactly why. I mean, this is amazing, and we're excited to see too, because we know the shearers are coming today.
They are.
And we're going to get a little, just we just want to see what is entailed to take the wool off of these animals.
No, we shear our sheep twice a year.
Yeah.
And we do that prior to parturition, the ewes giving birth. We do it about 90 days before they lamb. For sanitation reasons, it's easier for the lambs to nurse. And also, sheep are very arctic, so especially during the early spring or late winter, if they have a full coat of 2 or 3 inch wool on it,
they want to go
they'll go outside and lay in the snow. They're perfectly happy out there.
Yeah.
We do not want them having new babies out there in the snow.
Right. So again, it's a important thing to do for comfort.
It's animal management.
Safety.
Yes.
Animal management. Well, thank you very much for having us. Again, we're here talking sheep, and we can get your product, the local farmers market, Farm Fresh RI.
We have a store here at the farm.
There's a farm store. We saw the sign when we came in. A lot of local restaurants use the product, and we're so grateful that you guys do this, because without these products, it would be boring for us to cook, and customers would have nothing to look forward to coming in.
On that note, Matt, before we wind up, the local restaurants have been a very important part of us surviving.
Oh, they get nervous when they hear restaurants. Sorry.
And I truly enjoy working with those chefs like yourself a huge amount that really appreciate product, and they care where it comes from.
Yeah, it's important.
It's a great sector of the food
industry. And we're lucky too, as one real, being in Rhode Island, everything is fairly close. The amount of resources we have as far as restaurateurs for local is just amazing. And it's people like you that continue to do this, and it's so important for us.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so off next, we'll go see some shearing of sheep.